Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. As a university professor, when I think about how to introduce generative artificial intelligence or GenAI tools into my assessments, I tend to draw upon six important tips that I've developed. Now, these are tips that I've gleaned from my reading, research and experience, and I want to share them with you in the hope that you find them useful too. But before we explore these tips, please make sure to hit the subscribe button as it helps with the YouTube analytics. At the end of the video, I'll also provide a link to more detailed videos I've developed for using AI in teaching and assessment. So let's get started. Normally, to use the tips we're going to explore, you'd introduce GenAI into your assessments in one of two ways, and these normally tend to be: 1. GenAI tools can be used in an assistive capacity as part of the assessment, or 2. GenAI plays an integral role in the assessment. Let's look at each of these briefly before diving into the six tips. When you're using generative AI in an assistive capacity, you're asking your students to use AI tools for certain parts of their assessments. For example, you may ask them to use GenAI tools to boost skills in specific ways, such as data analysis, spotting patterns in large data sets, or creating new insights. As a tutor, you need to be clear that the GenAI tools should be used as guides, and you should support and guide the students in their process of learning to ensure equity. In using this approach, you also have to reinforce in the students that using AI isn't the end goal. It's more about leveling up their skills for future use. When using GenAI as an integral part of an assessment, students can normally use GenAI from start to finish. Here, you can assess how your students are using GenAI to tackle complex problems, to make critically informed decisions, and come up with creative solutions to the assessment tasks. In this assessment, you should allow your students the chance to prove that they can use GenAI in real world-like type situations. Again, as in the previous approach, you as the tutor should support and guide your students to ensure that there's equity in the learning experience. But whichever approach you decide to take, do remember that when creating your assessments, there might just be times when GenAI just isn't the right fit for the task. So you must ensure that you use it carefully in a considered way. Okay, so let's jump into the tips. I hope, like me, you find these useful before sitting down to consider using GenAI in your assessments. Check what your institution's regulations say in relation to how students can or cannot use AI in their assessments. Normally, there are regulations in place to ensure that no students gain unfair advantages over their peers when or if using GenAI in their assessments. Before expecting students to use AI tools like ChatGPT, Gemini, Copilot, etc. in their assessments, you have to make sure that all your students have equitable access to the tools required to use generative artificial intelligence tools. Please don't make the mistake of assuming that they have this access. Always check. Also, don't make the mistake of assuming that students are literate in the use of GenAI tools. Make sure that some type of critically reflective training is offered before students use these tools as part of their assessments. You need to do this to ensure fairness. And also remember that as the tutor, you should ensure that you act as a guide on the side in the use of GenAI to ensure that the students receive an equitable experience throughout the assessment process. It's really important also to ensure that any data students input into GenAI tools does not contain any personal, confidential, or sensitive data. Ensuring data safety is critically important because once in the system, that information may end up being used for many other purposes. It's important to ensure that your students are taught about how some GenAI results may contain biased outputs. So before students are allowed to use GenAI in their assessments, they must be taught about how the datasets their results draw upon may reinforce existing inequalities in society due to algorithmic bias. Students must be made aware that GenAI outputs can be inaccurate because they may contain fraudulent data. So it's important that students are taught to critically review and revise any outputs with other academic, professional, reputable, and peer-reviewed sources before using anything as part of their assessment submissions. I really hope you found these 6 tips helpful in helping you design your next GenAI-based assessments. Try to be creative in your assessments so that the learner's journey and the messy processes of learning and thinking are equally valued and rewarded as part of the assessment outputs. Because in the end, this learning journey, and not just necessarily the final outputs, will equip them for the amazing, challenging, AI-powered future that awaits them. But let's not end the conversation here. Use the comments box below and share your thoughts. What tips, for example, would you offer that I might have missed in this video? If you found this video useful, please make sure that you like it and consider subscribing to my channel. As promised, I've also put a link here to some other videos that you may find useful. I hope you've enjoyed exploring these 6 important tips into developing GenAI-powered academic assessments. I look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye.